Hello everyone. In this video, we shall derive the Poisson's integral formula. In fact, the Poisson's integral formula gives a method to determine a harmonic function u of z using only the boundary values in case of a closed disk. So that means if we consider any closed disk, for example, modulus of z less than or equal to r, so only using the boundary values, that is only using the u of z values for modulus of z is equal to r, so we can find u of z for rest of the z values, that is for all points interior for the closed disk mod z less than or equal to r. So Poisson's integral formula gives a relation, or it gives a formula to find u of z in the interior of a closed disk using only the boundary values. That means if you are known with u of z values for all modulus of z is equal to r, that is for all points on the circle, if you know what are u of z, then you can find all u of z points for all points in the interior of that circle. So which is a powerful formula to determine a harmonic function inside a closed disk using only the boundary values. So the theorem is like this. Suppose u of z is harmonic in the open disk mod z less than r and continuous on the closed disk mod z less than or equal to r, then u of a for any point a with modulus of a less than r, u of a is given by 1 by 2 pi integral r square minus modulus of a whole square by modulus of z minus a whole square into u of z d theta. So observe this formula carefully. So on the right hand side, to evaluate the right hand side, so what we need? We need u of z for all modulus of z equal to r. That means if you know what are u of z for all points on the circle modulus of z equal to r, then for any point a inside the circle, that is for any point a with modulus of a less than r, then u of a can be expressed in the form 1 by 2 pi integral r square minus modulus of a square by z minus a whole square into u of z d theta. So this gives a formula to determine u inside the closed disk using only the boundary values. So this formula is called Poisson's integral formula or Poisson's formula. So now we shall prove it. So first we shall generalize it. First we shall prove the result with the assumption that u of z is harmonic in the closed disk mod z less than or equal to r. In fact, in the hypothesis they have given u of z is harmonic in the open disk. So first we shall make a stronger assumption. So suppose u of z is harmonic in the closed disk mod z less than or equal to r. With this stronger assumption, we shall prove the result. Later on, we shall make the hypothesis weaker, right? So now consider a linear transformation defined by S of z equals r into r z plus a by r plus a bar z. This is defined for any point a with modulus of a less than r. So you know what is a linear transformation? A linear transformation is nothing but a rational function of degree 1. That is, it will be a rational function where the numerator and denominator will have the degree at most 1. Right? Now, we can observe that. So this linear transformation actually maps all the complex numbers xi with modulus of xi less than or equal to 1 onto modulus of z less than or equal to r. If I take S of xi as z, so if I consider image of xi under S as z, then all the xi's with this condition are mapped onto the z with modulus of z less than or equal to r. So or just diagrammatically, I can say S is a mapping from the closed disk mod z less than or equal to 1 to the closed disk mod z less than or equal to r. So it is a function from this closed disk to this closed disk, and it is also a onto map. Onto map means for every point in the codomain, there is a point in the domain whose image is the considered point in the codomain. That is, for any z here, there is a xi such that s of xi is nothing but z. So that means this function, yes, covers all the points of the closed disk mod z less than or equal to r. So the two points which you have to observe here is, s is a function from the closed disk mod z less than or equal to 1 to the closed disk mod z less than or equal to r. That is, if you consider any xi with modulus of xi less than or equal to 1, then calculate s of xi with this formula. The z which you will get will have the modulus of z less than or equal to r. So it is a simple word to verify. So just verify it that for any xi with modulus of xi less than or equal to 1, s of xi is taken as z, and where z will be with modulus of z less than or equal to r. So all these xi's are mapped on to the z with mod z less than or equal to r. And it is mapped in a onto way. That is, this map covers all the points in the closed disk mod z less than or equal to r. Right. Now, u of s of xi. Consider u of s of xi. So, previously we have observed that. So, these s of xi's will nothing but give you z as xi varies over the closed disk mod z less than or equal to 1. So, as xi varies over the closed disk modulus xi less than or equal to 1. So, s of xi gives you z with modulus of z less than or equal to r. So, if I consider the function u of s of xi with xi less than or equal to 1, modulus of xi less than or equal to 1, then s of xi nothing but varies over z with modulus of z less than or equal to r. But u of z is harmonic in modulus of z less than or equal to r. So, u of s of xi will be harmonic in modulus of xi less than or equal to 1, as s of xi will nothing but give you z with modulus of z less than or equal to r. So just in place of s of xi, I can write z with modulus of z less than or equal to r. So these values will be nothing but from this range. So u of z will be harmonic in that region. So u of s of xi will be harmonic in modulus of xi less than or equal to 1. Now, u of s of xi is harmonic in the closed disk mod z less than or equal to 1. Now, we shall use the mean value property. So, mean value property says that if you use any harmonic function in some open disk or closed disk, then over any circle in that open disk or closed disk, so this result holds. Now, I'll consider the circle with center 0, radius 1. That is, I'll consider the boundary circle itself. So, over this circle, integral u of s of xi into d of argument of xi. So, just I'll recall what is the mean value theorem. So, if I consider the unit closed disk. So, if I assume u is harmonic in the closed disk mod z less than or equal to 1, then so u of 0 is equal to 1 by 2 pi integral u of z d theta over any circle mod z equals to r in this closed disk, right? So this is the mean value theorem. So mean value theorem states that if u is harmonic in some open disk, or you can consider closed disk also. So, if u is assumed to be a harmonic in this closed disk, then u of 0, that is center of this closed disk, u of 0 will be equal to 1 by 2 pi u of z d theta over any circle in this closed disk. You can consider any circle, right, where theta is actually taken as the argument of z. So, now I'll write the same thing in terms of xi. So, u of s of 0, because here xi is the variable and 0 is the center of this closed disk. So, u of s of xi is harmonic in this closed disk. So, 0 is the center of the closed disk. So, u of s of 0 is equal to 1 by 2 pi integral u of S of xi, because S of xi's are the variables here, into D of argument of the variable, argument of xi, where you can consider this integral over any circle in this closed disk. Now I am considered the boundary circle itself. That is, I have considered the circle with center 0, radius 1. Now we shall see what happens. So now, what are xi's? Xi's are actually numbers varying over the unit circle. That is, they are all the points which are at a distance 1 from origin. So now, for all these points, we can have the polar form. So polar form says that, polar form is, for any complex number z, polar form is modulus of z into e to the power I into argument of z. This is the polar form of any complex number. So if I want to write xi in the polar form, so xi can be written as modulus of xi into e to the power I into argument of xi. So anyhow, modulus of xi is equal to 1. We have considered all xi with mod xi equals to 1. Hence, argument of xi. You can take any variable for argument of xi. So we shall take phi. So xi will be of the form e to the power phi, where phi is taken as the argument of xi. So with this substitution, the formula takes, the mean value property formula takes the form u of a, because on the left hand side we have s of 0, and s of 0 is a by our linear transformation s. So the linear transformation s which we have considered maps 0 onto a. So u of a equals 1 by 2 pi integral u of s of xi d argument of xi, which is phi, over the unit circle mod xi equals 1. Now compare this with the Poisson's integral formula which we have to derive. So this is the Poisson's integral formula, which is given by u of a equals 1 by 2 pi integral r square minus modulus of a square by modulus of z minus a whole square u of z d theta. So which is has to be defined for all a with mod a less than r. So the left hand side we have already got, it is u of a. So just we have to rewrite the right hand side. Here observe that phi. So we are here, the integral is in terms of xi and phi. So phi is anyhow related to xi. So we shall write it in terms of xi later on. Then xi is related to z by this linear transformation, right? All the xi's are mapped onto z. So we shall later on write this integral in terms of xi as in terms of z. Then by taking theta as the argument of z, we shall write this integral in the form of z and theta. So which will be the required integral? Observe that the right hand side integral is of the form z and theta, where we have to take theta as the argument of z. So this is the flow. So now this is the integral what we have in our AND, which is true for all a with mod a less than r. So which is in terms of xi and phi, we shall convert this integral in terms of z and theta. So that is the only work. Now this integral is over the circle mod xi equals 1. So for all those points, so differentiate this relation. So d xi will be equal to I into e power I phi d phi, or e power I phi is nothing but xi. So take that to the left hand side and I to the left hand side. So it will be minus I into d xi by xi, which will be d phi. Right. Now we converted phi also in terms of xi. Now we have to convert xi in terms of z. So for that, the linear transformation comes to help. So the linear transformation, what we have is z is equal to r into r xi plus a by r plus a bar xi. So now we have this integral in terms of xi. So we shall convert this expression in terms of xi, right? So xi has to be expressed in terms of z, so that we can replace xi terms with z terms. So we'll get the integral in terms of z and theta. So now we shall resolve this linear transformation to express xi in terms of z. So for that, take all xi terms one side, z terms other side. So the first of all, cross multiply it, z into r plus a bar z equals r into r z plus a. So multiply the things, take all z terms one side, the remaining terms the other side. So z common, so z will be r into z minus a by r square minus a bar z. So now we shall take log for this expression. Log z will be equal to log of r into z minus a by r square minus a bar z. Now we use the formula, log a by b is log a minus log b. So log of r into z minus a by r square minus a bar z will be log of r into z minus a minus log of r square minus a bar z. Once again, here we have the form log a into b. It is log a plus log b. So log of r into z minus a will be log r plus log z minus a. Now we shall differentiate this equation. So differentiating this equation, so first differentiation of log xi, it is 1 by xi, then differentiation of xi equals log r is a constant, differentiation is 0, and now log of z minus a, its differentiation is 1 by z minus a, and differentiation of z is dz, minus log of r square minus a bar z, differentiation is 1 by r square minus a bar z into differentiation of r square minus a bar z is minus a bar into differentiation of z is dz. So on simplification, it is dz by z equals 1 by z minus a plus a bar by r square minus a bar z into dz. Right. Now, just we shall make some simplifications here. So consider the second term, that is a bar by r square minus a bar z. Now, for all z with mod z equals to r, with this condition, so r is nothing but modulus of z. So substitute it, a bar by, we know that modulus of z square is z into z bar. So a bar by z into z bar minus a bar z. So take z common in the denominator and multiply or cross multiply that to the left hand side, so that a bar z by r square minus a bar z is a bar by z minus a whole bar. So this is provided for all z with mod z equals to r. So that means, so we got a simpler form for the second term. So where we have to multiply z. So for that, so we shall multiply and divide by z to this equation. So what equation what we got here? Dz by z equals this one. So for this equation, multiply and divide by z. So that multiplied z will comes inside. So z by z minus a plus a bar z by r square minus a bar z divided by z. So this expression we have solved that. So that expression is, it is solved to a bar by z minus a whole bar. So just make the substitution. So dz by z will be z by z minus a plus a bar by z minus a whole bar dz by z. So this is true for all z with mod z equals to r. So why we have calculated for these values, I'll tell later. Now, for all these values, for all z with mod z equals to r. So once again, we shall express those numbers in the polar form. So to express z in the polar form, I have to write it as z is equal to mod z into e to the power I argument of z. So anyhow, modulus of z is r into e to the power I into. I have to take argument of z with some notation. So take it as theta. So z will be equal to r e power I theta, where theta is the argument of z. Now differentiate this expression. So it will be dz equals I into r e power I theta d theta. So r is constant. So differentiation of e power I theta is I into e power I theta. Differentiation of theta is d theta. So dz will be equal to I z d theta, or d theta will be minus I into dz by z. So we can convert z in terms of d theta. Now, to this expression, multiply minus I on both sides, so that minus I into d xi by xi is d phi, minus I into dz by z is d theta, and which is true for all z with mod z equals r. Okay, now we shall just simplify this part, which is in the inside the brackets. So just cross multiply the things, so you'll get z minus a whole bar is multiplied with z, and z minus a is multiplied with a bar, and cross multiply the denominator. So on simplification, you will get r square minus modulus of a square by z minus a whole square. And once again, it is done for all z with mod z equals r. Okay. So bracketed expression can be replaced by r square minus modulus of a square by modulus of z minus a whole square d theta. Now, so what we have initially using the mean value property, we have u of a equals 1 by 2 pi u of s of xi d phi over the circle modulus of xi is equal to 1, which is true for all a with modulus of a less than r. That means this, the right hand side which you have to modify. So the right hand side integral is over modulus of xi is equal to 1. And we have to express xi in terms of z. Xi in terms of z. And now we observe that there is a 1-to-1 correspondence between the unit circle modulus of xi is equal to 1 and the circle modulus of z is equal to r. That means any xi with mod xi is equal to 1 corresponds to a z with mod z is equal to r. And conversely, any z with this condition corresponds to a xi with mod xi is equal to 1. So there is a 1-to-1 correspondence between these numbers and these numbers, so that I can replace all xi with mod xi equals to 1 with z with mod z equals to r. So that is what we observe here. So for any xi with mod xi equals to 1, so this is the relation between xi and z, which is given by the linear transformation. Yes. So consider s of xi to be, which is z, given by r into r xi plus a by r plus a bar xi. So now we shall simplify modulus of z. So take square on both sides. Modulus of z whole square equals modulus of r into r xi plus a by r plus a bar xi whole square. So just simplify the right hand side. So split the square, then r square into r xi plus a whole square divided by modulus of a bar xi plus r whole square. So now just we shall use the identity modulus of a plus b whole square for any complex numbers a and b. It is defined as modulus of a square plus modulus of b square plus 2 into real part of a into b bar. So if I use this identity, it will be modulus of r xi whole square plus modulus of a square plus 2 into real part of r xi into a bar. So the same thing has been done in the denominator also. Then use the fact that modulus of xi is equal to 1. So finally, you will get r square in the right hand side. So modulus of z square is equal to r square. So taking positive square root on both sides, you will get modulus of z is equal to r. So this shows that any xi with modulus of xi is equal to 1 is corresponding to, it is related to any z with modulus of z is equal to r. And the same thing can be repeated in the reverse direction. That is, if we consider any z with mod z equals to r, so reversing the linear transformation, so it corresponds to a xi with modulus of xi is equal to 1. That means we can observe a 1-to-1 correspondence between the unit circle mod z equals 1 and the circle mod z is equal to r. So these two have a 1-to-1 correspondence using the linear transformation. Yes. So these points have a 1-to-1 correspondence with these points. That means these points can be replaced by these points. So we shall do it. So the equation one, which we have considered, can be rewritten as, so u of a equals 1 by 2 pi u of s of xi d phi for all a with modulus of a less than r. Here xi is varying with mod xi is equal to 1, so which can be replaced by z with mod z equals to r. So all those S of Xi's can will be replaced by Z, because the linear transformation S of Xi gives you the value Z. And what is D phi? D phi is R square minus modulus of a whole square by modulus of Z minus a whole square into D theta. So which is nothing but the required Poisson's integral formula. So we got U of A is equal to 1 by 2 pi R square minus modulus of A square by modulus of Z minus A whole square U of Z d theta for any A with modulus of A less than R. And hence we got the result with the assumption that U of Z is harmonic in the closed disk mod Z less than or equal to R. So assuming a stronger hypothesis, we got the result. Now we shall make the hypothesis weaker. So now assume U of Z is harmonic in modulus of Z less than R. Once again, to obtain the same Poisson's integral formula, we shall introduce a positive R less than 1. So using this R, we shall make some necessary changes to obtain the same Poisson's integral formula under the assumption that U of Z is harmonic in the open disk mod Z less than R. So R be any positive real less than 1, define R dash to be R into R. As we are multiplying a positive value less than 1, R into R will be less than R. Take Xi to be R into Z for all Z with mod Z less than R. Then their modulus, modulus of Xi, modulus of RZ, R into modulus of Z. So if I consider Z with mod Z is less than R, so R into modulus of Z will be less than or equal to R into capital R, but R into capital R is R dash. So modulus of Xi's are all less than or equal to R dash, and R dash in turn is less than R. And now consider modulus of R into A. It is R into modulus of A less than R into capital R. For all modulus of A less than R, R into modulus of A will be less than R into capital R, which is R dash. So now observe that. So we have made the assumption that U of Z is harmonic for all Z with mod Z less than R. Now if I consider U of Xi for all Xi with Xi equals RZ. So as modulus of Xi is less than or equal to R dash, which is less than R. So for all these Xi values, modulus of Xi is less than R. So U of Xi will be harmonic in modulus of Xi less than or equal to R dash. If we consider all Xi with modulus of Xi less than or equal to R dash, as it is less than R, so by this condition. So whatever the complex number you take, its modulus is less than R means for that value U of Z is harmonic. So here modulus of Xi is less than R for all these values. So U of Xi will be harmonic. So U of Xi is harmonic in modulus of Xi less than or equal to R dash as it is less than R, and modulus of R into A is less than R dash. So now we shall apply the above part what we have proved to this. So in the above part, we proved that. So whenever U of Z is harmonic in the closed disk, mod Z less than or equal to R, and if A is any point with modulus of A less than R, so we got the Poisson's integral formula. So now we have the same situation. So now U of Z is harmonic in modulus of Z less than or equal to R dash, and R into A are numbers whose modulus value is less than R dash. So in place of Z, we have Xi, and in place of the closed disk mod Z less than or equal to R, we have the closed disk mod Z less than or equal to R dash. And in place of numbers A, we have R into A. So apply the above part for this situation. So then by the above part, we have in place of A, RA. So U of RA equals 1 by 2 pi integral R dash whole square minus R into A modulus square by Xi minus RA whole square into U of Xi d theta for all numbers modulus of RA less than R dash, where the circle is modulus of R equal to R dash. So just I have applied the above part for this situation. So you correspondingly will get the result, this one. Now, just simplify the right hand side. So u of r a equals 1 by 2 pi, xi is nothing but r into z. So u of r z d theta, and modulus of xi is equal to r dash. So use the substitution. So xi is nothing but r z, r dash is nothing but r into r. So r r gets cancelled, modulus of z is equal to r. So you'll get this one. Then what about this one? So modulus, that is r dash square minus modulus of r a square by modulus of xi minus r a whole square is there. So just simplify it using our substitutions. So what are the substitution or what we have done? So use those substitutions. You will get this term is nothing but r square minus modulus of a square by z into a square. So substitute it. You will get finally this one. So but this is not the exact Poisson's integral formula because we have a variable r here. So we have to remove it. So what is r? R is any value between 0 and 1. So and this integral is true for any r value. So whatever the r value between 0 and 1, so we got this result. So now to get the Poisson's integral formula, just we have to remove this r. So for that, we shall use the continuity of u. So as r approaches to 1. So r is any value between 0 and 1. Now bring r closer and closer to 1. Bring r closer and closer to 1. As r comes closer and closer to 1, u of r a approaches u of a because u is continuous. U is continuous at a. So u of r a, as r approaches 1, r into a. Numbers r into a will approach to a, obviously. So that as r a approaches a, u of r a should approach to u of a because u is continuous at a. So as for numbers r coming closer and closer to 1, u of r a are nothing but u of a. So that we can replace u of r a by u of a now for r values which are very closer to 1. Next we have to replace these u of rz. Here a was fixed. For any fixed a, this integral is true. But here z is varying. R is also varying. Z is also varying. So u of rz. Here we cannot apply continuity. We need uniform continuity. So since u is continuous on the closed and bounded set, modulus of z less than or equal to r, u will be uniformly continuous on modulus of z less than or equal to r. So it is uniformly continuous means what? For every epsilon, there is a delta such that distance between u of z1 and u of z2 can be made less than epsilon whenever the distance between z and z1 and z2 is less than delta for any two points z1 and z2 in the domain of u. So this is what the definition of uniform continuity. Now, let epsilon greater than 0 be any positive value. So, the corresponding to this epsilon value, take delta to be epsilon into r. Now, as r approaches to 1, so distance between r and 1 can be made less than any epsilon value. So, distance between rz and z can be made less than delta. So, as distance between rz and z is less than delta, by uniform continuity, distance between u of rz and u of z can be made less than epsilon. That means, as r approaches 1, u of rz are approaching to u of z. So, as r comes closer and closer to 1, u of rz values are approaching to u of z. So, that means, so this integral is true for any r value between 0 and 1. Now just tend r to 1 or bring r closer and closer to 1. Then these u of r a values will coincide with u of a and u of r z values will coincide with u of z. So that is what we get finally. Thus we get u of a is equal to 1 by 2 pi integral r square minus modulus of a square by modulus of z minus a whole square into u of z d theta over the circle modulus of z equals to r for any point a with modulus of a less than r, which is the Poisson's integral formula. And this Poisson's integral formula actually gives you a formula to determine u of a values using only the boundary values. Okay, now we shall make note of some important points in the Poisson's integral formula. So by the above theorem, the Poisson's formula or Poisson's integral formula is given by u of a is equal to 1 by 2 pi integral r square minus modulus of a square by modulus of z minus a whole square into u of z d theta over the circle mod z equals r for all the points with modulus of a less than r. So actually this formula serves to express the harmonic function u through its values on the circle mod z equals to r. So if you are known with the u of z values on the circle mod z equals to r, then we can express u of a in the disk mod z mod a less than r. So using the values on the circle of u, so we can express u inside the circle. So this is a very important formula in expressing a harmonic function inside a disk using the values on the circle, right? Now just we shall make some modifications in the Poisson's integral formula. So in the theorem, so we used this substitution for d phi. So d phi is r square minus modulus of a square by modulus of z minus a whole square into d theta. So now we shall simplify it in some other way. So for mod z equals to r, so r square is modulus of z whole square minus modulus of a square by modulus of z minus a whole square. So modulus of z square means z into z bar minus a into a bar by z minus a into z minus a whole bar. So just I'm using the identity modulus of z square is z into z bar. Now multiply and divide by 2. So here in the numerator, we have 2 times of z into z bar minus a into a bar. So we have this term 2 times now. Here now add and subtract minus a bar z and a z bar. So here minus a bar z plus a bar z plus a z bar minus a z bar. So gets cancelled. We will get the same thing once again. That is 2 times of z into z bar minus a into a bar. So the 2 times of z into z bar minus a into a bar is written as this term plus this term. Right. Now take common z here, z bar minus a bar plus a is common, z bar minus a bar plus here z common, z bar is common, z minus a, here a bar is common, z minus a. So here z plus a is common, here z bar plus a bar is common. So finally we will get half times of z plus a by z minus a plus z plus a whole bar by z minus a whole bar, or it is half times of z plus a by z minus a plus z plus a by z minus a whole bar. It is of the form half into z plus z bar. So it is nothing but real part of z. So it will be, so this nothing but will be real part of z. So just make a substitution that, so in place of r square minus modulus of a square by z minus a whole square, so we can write real part of z plus a by z minus a. So just make that substitution. So with this simplification, the Poisson's integral formula takes the other form as u of a equals 1 by 2 pi. So real part of z plus a by z minus a into u of z d theta over the circle mod z equals to r with points modulus of a less than r. So now just we shall change the notation. So in place of a, we take z, and in place of z, we shall take xi. So with this change of notation, the Poisson's integral formula can be rewritten as u of z equals 1 by 2 pi integral real part of xi plus z by xi minus z into u of z d theta over the circle mod xi equals r for all points z with mod z less than r. Right? So as u is a harmonic function, so real part of u of z is u of z only, because u is a real valued function. All harmonic functions are real valued functions. So for any z, u of z is a real number. So this is a real number. So real part of a real number is itself. So u of z can be written as real part of u of z. So real part of a into real part of b is real part of a into b. So real part of u of z into real part of z plus z by z minus z is real part of this product, that is z plus z by z minus z into u of z. And now we have integral of the real part. So integral of the real part is nothing but real part of the integral, real part of the integral. And on this circle, mod z equals to r. So we have minus z into d z is d theta. So instead of d theta, I will write minus I by d z by z. Or finally, u of z takes the form real part of 1 by 2 pi I integral z plus z by z minus z into u of z by z d z over the circle mod z equals to r for all points with modulus of z less than r. So this is also the same Poisson's formula. So in the other notation, that's it. So this identity is also called the Poisson's formula itself. Okay, now observe the expression which we have inside the bracket. That is 1 by 2 pi I integral z plus z by z minus z u of z by z into dz. So now we shall verify that it is a analytic function. So this expression which is inside the brackets on the right hand side is an analytic function. Now we assert that the bracketed expression is an analytic function. So consider that. So this was the bracketed expression. This was the expression which was in the bracket. So now consider it. So just we shall make some simplification to show that it is an analytic function, right? So z plus z is there. It can be written as 2z minus z. So with this, separate the terms z minus z and 2z. So that 1 plus 2z by z minus z. So with this, separate the integral. So 1 times of u of z by z and 2z by z minus z times of u of z by z. So we have split it into two integrals. Now once again, d z by z into minus I. Here, 2z by z into u of z in the numerator, z minus z in the denominator. So just we are making some simple changes, right? Next, so in place of minus I into d z by z, I can substitute d theta and take that numerator as g of z. So what is g of z? It is 2z into u of z by z. So actually, for a fixed point with mod z less than r, z is constant. So g is a function of z. Now, using mean value property or mean value theorem, 1 by 2 pi integral u of z d theta over the circle mod z equals to r will nothing but give you u of 0. So u of 0 by the mean value theorem, so which is a constant, plus 1 by 2 pi I g of z by z, z minus z d z over the circle mod z equals r. Right? So now, u of 0 being a constant is analytic function, and this function is also analytic, as g of z is a continuous function on this closed arc. So here I'm using the lemma. So if phi of z is a continuous function in an arc gamma, then fn of z, function fn of z defined by integral phi of z by z minus z whole power n over the arc gamma is analytic in the regions determined by gamma. That means this function will be analytic everywhere except on gamma. Here also, so g of z, so it is a continuous function on the circle mod z equals to r. As I vary z over the circle mod z equals to r, g of z is a continuous function. So it is a continuous function on the closed arc mod z is equal to r. So the function, so here just in place of n, we have 1. So just using this lemma, using this lemma. So take n is equal to 1, then g of xi is a continuous function on this closed arc. So the integral g of xi by xi minus z whole power 1 d xi will be an analytic function. Any analytic function, scalar multiple of analytic function is once again an analytic function. So thus, the thing which we have on the right hand side, that is u of 0 plus 1 by 2 pi I integral g of xi by xi minus z d xi. So this is an analytic function. It is an analytic function. So which is an analytic function in the disk mod z less than r. So that is what we got. We got 1 by 2 pi I integral xi plus z by xi minus z into u of xi by xi d xi over the circle mod xi equals to r is an analytic function. It is any analytic function plus any constant is also analytic function. Just as we are generalizing the expression. So this expression is an analytic function. So if I take it as f of z, so f of z will be analytic in the disk mod z less than r. And it is called the Schwarz formula. So this is called the Schwarz formula. So that is, we note that by the Poisson's integral formula, what the expression for u of z we get. So it is the real part of an analytic function. The Poisson's formula, what we get for the harmonic function u is nothing but u is expressed as real part of analytic function, because here you can observe. So finally, we arrived at the expression where u of z is in terms of real part of a function, real part of some expression. And later on, we proved that expression is an analytic function. We proved this as expression is an analytic function. Thus, u of z is represented as real part of an analytic function. And that analytic function is nothing but called the Schwarz formula. So we'll call this as Schwarz formula. And the Poisson's formula actually expresses u of z in terms of real part of an analytic function. So this is the important things which you have to note at the end of Poisson's integral formula.